Project 369, Manifesting Through Project 369 and the Law of Attraction, Methods, Techniques and Exercises. Written by World Press. Narrated by Derik Hendrickson and Pete Seymour.
Have you ever heard that the mind affects our life and the things that happen to us? Our mind is very powerful. Yes, it is. And if we combine our power with universal law, we can truly change our lives, improving our relationships, our home, our professional life, and even our economic situation. Life isn't about finding yourself. Life is about creating yourself. George Bernard Shaw. Introduction. Universe is a system that is moved and regulated by energy, of which we ourselves are part. In fact, energy manifests itself through vibrations that are emitted on certain frequencies. This is how things move, by way of attraction, and so it also happens for men. If we tune our minds to the right frequency, we can only attract exactly what we want. It will be precisely the energy through the vibrations we emit that will bring the object of our desire towards us. Translated into simpler words, all we have to do is clearly visualize in our mind what we want, think we are on the way to obtaining it, and await the work of the universe with confidence and gratitude. It is good to know that it is not just an episode to be put into practice to obtain a given desire, but rather a new way of thinking, more virtuous and aware, which favors, above all, positive thinking and the art of gratitude. Method 369 is basically an exercise that is based on some basic principles of Nikola Tesla and Abraham Hicks, and aims to lead to the fulfillment of a wish. Nikola Tesla believed that there was a close relationship between the numbers 3, 6, and 9. Tesla had the fundamental aim of his studies throughout his life to bring electricity to the whole world for free. He carried out several studies and projects, but at the base of his research, there was always a strong focus on numbers, in particular the numbers 3, 6, 9. He had observed, through the study of some mathematical formulas, that these numbers always repeat themselves, and he was firmly convinced that they were the basis of the origin of everything in the universe. It is said that he believed in these three numbers so much that he set his life around these figures. He stayed in hotel rooms whose number was divisible by three. Before returning home, it was said that he always made three rounds of the block and finally chewed his food, always following this pattern. Abraham Hicks states that if we focus on a thought by the law of attraction, we attract energy, and what we have thought expands to manifest itself on the physical plane. Have you ever heard that the mind affects our life and the things that happen to us? Here, this simple sentence contains the essence of the principle underlying the law of attraction. According to the theory, in fact, our thoughts have the power to influence what happens to us, attracting what we want and helping us to live the life that we want. How? By harnessing the energy of the universe and the complex system of vibrations and frequencies by which it is regulated. However naive and simplistic it may seem at first approach, it is a consideration that has its roots in deep-rooted scientific certainties, so much so that it is reflected in the observations of Albert Einstein, who, with this phrase, initially referring to a physical principle, initiates, unknowingly, the theory of the law of attraction as we know it today. Everything is energy, and this is all there is. Tune into the frequency of the reality you want, and you can't help but get that reality. From these first considerations, it clearly emerges how our attitude and our will become essential in the creation of our destiny, and how much the latter is in our power, although we often tend to forget it. In fact, as we will see shortly, Mental predisposition is a key step in applying the law of attraction and succeeding in living the life we want. For this to happen, however, it is necessary to establish a connection with oneself, in simpler words, to love and trust oneself unconditionally. Below, we suggest some small exercises to increase your self-esteem and love yourself more. Our mind is very powerful. Yes, it is. And if we combine our power with universal law, we can truly change our lives, improving our relationships, our home, our professional life, and even our economic situation. Method 3, 6, 9. How do you make a wish come true? First of all, we must believe that what we are wishing for can come true. However, it is not enough to write our desire. The drafting must be done following small tricks, which we will see later. Method 369. What is it for? Paper and pen. Get a notebook or diary that is dedicated only to your wishes and a pen that you particularly like. It begins. Keep your desire firmly in mind. Remember that you have to believe it is possible. Write your wishes, starting the sentence with "I want," followed by the verbs to be, to do, to receive, and to have. You will have to decide when to do the exercise, as you will have to do it 3 times during the day. You must always have your notebook with you and do the exercise every day. In the first session, e.g., 7:30 a.m., you will have to write your wish 3 times. In the second session, 2 in the afternoon, you will have to write it 6 times. And 9 times in the third and last session, e.g., 9:30 p.m. You have to write with thanks just as if your wish has already come true. As you write it, imagine your life and what it would be like if what you want were a reality, and describe the sensations you feel. Repeating something 18 times a day is basically overwriting. It works just like a computer. Reset the old one and install the new one. The reprogramming changes all those beliefs that have been fixed within us through the experiences and education received in school and in the family. What prevents you from fulfilling your wishes? Limiting beliefs are written within us just as if we were a blackboard. However, just delete them and replace them with thoughts that we like more and make us feel better. Furthermore, writing the desire as if it were already a reality allows us to gain confidence and optimism that what we are asking for truly can come true. Here are some examples of writing a wish. I want to have a fit body. Thank you, universe, for giving me a body that I like. I finally feel fit, light, full of energy. I can move more easily, I can eat much better, and this makes me feel good about myself. I look in the mirror, and I like myself. I see myself as beautiful. I can take beautiful walks. I like being outdoors, breathing in the sense of the seasons, feeling the wind on my face. I want to have economic security. I can buy things I want: a necklace, a toy for my son, an object for the house. I manage to pay my bills, and at the end of the month I have some money left over which I can save to give my children a better future, or to take a trip if they want to. I am finally free to decide what I want to do, where to go, and when to do it. In the book, you will find tips and techniques for applying this method that will change your life. 8 exercises to cultivate gratitude and feel happier. Can the happiness muscle be trained? According to numerous scientific studies, cultivating a sense of gratitude in daily life helps to feel more satisfied, happy, and brings various benefits for psychophysical well-being. When we feel genuinely and deeply grateful for something we have recognized as important, we experience a sense of fulfillment, satisfaction, happiness. Often these feelings do not last long, but with constant training we can learn to generate a state of mind of fulfillment, cultivating gratitude for the positive things we take for granted. The muscle of gratitude. As we saw in the previous article, scientific results support the hypothesis that cultivating gratitude modifies brain activity. also reinforcing the ability to experience gratitude at the neuronal level. In other words, the more you train yourself to feel grateful.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.